Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes met een nieuwsupdate voor vandaag, 24 januari 2016. Dus het bulletin van zondag. This bulletin is in English, but we start with a small message in Dutch. Deze uitzending is als altijd in het weekend in het Engels. We hebben wel Contestia, maar geen slow-scan televisie. In plaats daarvan aan het eind van de uitzending een test, onder andere met automatisch omschakelen van FLDigi. In this bulletin we have several items in English, but we also do have Contestia as usual with 125 speed and 8 tones at 355 Hz. At the end of the show we are going to do some small tests including automatic switching by FLDigi.
Amateur Radio Newsline report number 1995 with a release date of Friday, January 22nd, 2016. Speaking of teamwork, a recent dip in the temperatures showed a group of hams and non-hams that cross-training isn't just for athletes. On Monday, January 18th, when Florida temperatures plummeted, Henry County, Florida Emergency Management deployed workers to two cold weather shelters on either side of the huge county. They included Andrew Frame, WD4RCC, and his wife Brandy, as well as Frank Harris Sr., WA4PAM. Both Frank and Andrew are EM reservists as well as hams. All the while, EM Director Brian Newhouse, KJ4WIC, transported supplies, the area's homeless, and did troubleshooting. With local municipal support, the hams, working with a trained group of non-hams, kept things running smoothly, according to Andrew Frame. He credits the recent emphasis on cross-training county emergency service responders and radio amateurs, and he said this cold snap was the first test of how well that cross-training across multiple disciplines really worked. He said, quote, "It puts everyone more or less on the same page, or at least the same chapter in the book," end quote. One of the next stages in cross-training, getting the community emergency response team volunteers ready for their technician license exam. If you think all the New Year's CW action has taken a short seasonal break, guess again. The Straight Key Century Club is keeping the excitement of Straight Key Night going strong right through the month of January. Here's Amateur Radio Newsline's Neil Rapp, WB9VPG.
January is turning out to be a key month in more ways than one for the Straight Key Century Club. The club's annual month-long event, K3Y, got underway on January 2 and continues through January 31. But this year it also marks the 10-year anniversary for this club of CW enthusiasts. The Straight Key Century Club was founded in 2006, following the ARRL Straight Key Night event that same year. The on-air party is an invitation to all hams to experiment with their Morse code skills using straight keys, bugs, and sideswipers. K3Y operators will be working stations in each of the U.S. call areas, and there will be other stations in each of the six IARU continental regions using call signs with KH6, KL7, and KP4. QSL cards and, of course, sweep certificates will also be available. By the way, there's no need to RSVP to this party. Just get on the air. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Neil Rapp, WB9VPG in Bloomington, Indiana.
Thank you, Neil. It's nice to have you on the Newsline team. Speaking of CW, there's reportedly a new record in distance for CW contacts in the UK, as reported on Southgate Amateur Radio News by the hams who say they've accomplished it. Ian Lamb, G8KQW, and John Hazell, G8ACE, claim to have set a new UK distance record for code on 134 GHz. The record-breaking contact is said to have occurred January 16th with the two amateurs utilizing a line-of-sight path from Chute Causeway near Andover all the way to Cheesefoot Head near Winchester. The distance covered? 35.6 kilometers, which is a little more than 22 miles. The previous UK record on 134 gigahertz was 19.2 kilometers and had been set by G8KQW and G8ACE on September 20th, 2015. And one more bit of news for CW enthusiasts, especially those who are proud to have a competitive edge. The UK and Ireland Contest Club will have its first annual DXCW Contest January 23rd and 24th, a 24-hour competition that starts at noon local time on Saturday. UK and EI districts are multipliers, as are other DXCC countries on each band from 80 to 10 meters. The exchange is your serial and two-character district code. Hams competing in EI and UK districts will need to know their district codes, which are listed in the rules at ukeicc.com. The contest will not have an exchange. Good luck. You may not be hungry for dinner right now, but it pays to plan ahead, especially if you're planning to enjoy the banquet on Saturday, February 13th at the ARRL National Convention at the Orlando Hamcation in Florida. Tickets are still available, but the cutoff date is January 31st. The evening's banquet keynote speaker will be ARRL CEO David Sumner, K1ZZ, who is retiring this spring. Master of Ceremonies will be ARRL Southeastern Division Director Doug Riemann, K4AC. Both the convention and Hamcation will offer a menu of other events beyond the banquet, but the dinner gathering is going to be a big deal, so you need to plan. So reserve now. Banquet tickets, like the banquet itself, will be all gobbled up soon. Ham Radio is romancing the tinkerers and the makers again, this time in Germany. The Deutsche Amateur Radio Club, Germany's national nonprofit radio organization, took its place at a maker and hacker event in Munich earlier this month in an attempt to capture the imagination and creativity of the more than 7,500 attendees. The two-day hobbyist fair, known as Make Munich, is a major do-it-yourself festival where lovers of technology and tinkering with technology stretch their dreams in new directions. According to a report on DARC's webpage, which quotes Marcus Heller, DL8RDS, the group's booth attracted numerous inquiries about amateur license courses and exams. The same report noted that many visitors signed the DARC guestbook and included the call sign they already had, even from their home countries, such as the U.S. and Finland. The first Iranian ham contest kicks off on February 1st and runs through February 11th, marking the 37th anniversary of the Iranian Islamic Revolution. The contest's goal is simple. Organizers want to encourage and increase new contacts with Iranian hams, and they're placing a special emphasis on DXing. Find the action on 40, 20, 15, and 10 meters in single sideband RTTY and CW modes. QSL cards and certificates will be available. For further information, send an email to epcontest.2016@gmail.com.
From Australia, this is VK1WIA.
Discussion point. And are we in a sexist pursuit? On air, you may hear an amateur radio station say, "Well, OM, your signals are fine," and a courteous reply to that transmission may be, "Thanks a lot, YL, you are putting in a good signal too." If it was a CW contact and greetings were warranted, then it could be 73 and 88. The hobby of amateur radio is not sexist. The setting up of ALARA in 75 and then the foundation license just 10 years ago saw many more women enter amateur radio. Now we have Yvette Senders, KB3HTS, in the limelight, who says from her experience she's had enough of creepy old guy comments. The astrophysicist says that ham radio is not terribly good at making women feel like they belong. After what she calls patronising comments during QSOs, she's put a personal ban on the term YL. Maybe the creepy old guys did not mean exactly what they said, or perhaps there's a degree of sensitivity shown by the receiver. Hang on a bit. The same creepy old guy gets the blame for shunning Z calls, then novices, and more lately, standards on 20 metres and the foundation licence holder. Our heritage includes terms like old man, old boy, young lady, and ex-young lady, for those who prefer their marital status to be known. The hobby of amateur radio has always included both genders, and we should not and do not need discriminate.
Right now, we are going to do some small tests with some digimodes. First, we go up with the audio filter and the Contestia frequency. Filter should be now at 440 Hz and Contestia at 373 Hz. This is a test with Contestia. Test with Contestia. Test with Contestia. This is a test with Contestia. Now we will speed up things a little bit more. Filter is now at 570 Hz. I hope you can still read what I say. Contestia is now at 435 Hz with 250 speed. This is a test with Contestia. Test with Contestia. This is a test with Contestia. Test with Contestia.